Hi everyone, it's November 25th, 2021. So happy Thanksgiving. Whether you're spending it quietly or having a party with family and friends, I hope you're having a wonderful time. And don't forget to count your blessings. Today, I'll show you one of the things that I'm most grateful for, especially in the wintertime, and that's my camellia plants in containers. I have 4 camellias out on my patio right now in containers, and I look out onto these plants from my living room when I feel a little depressed because it can be a little gloomy and rainy here in the wintertime. I mean, I say a little, but it's kind of like most days in the winter here for us. But let me show you my first one.
Before I begin, I should add that I'm gardening in Zone 8 in the Pacific Northwest. And even though winter here can be gloomy and rainy, it is a mild winter. It's mild enough for me to be able to enjoy the beautiful camellias, which are hardy up to Zone 8 and sometimes down to Zone 7. This is Camellia japonica. It's a variety called debutante. It is a strikingly beautiful camellia. Compared to my other 3 camellias, the leaves are a little bit bigger and broader. It is medium green with like lighter green undersides. To the touch, it feels a little thick and a little bit coarse, but I guess that would have to be that way to be able to survive winter. I haven't had any disease problems with this. I have a little bit of brown spots here and there, but I don't think they're harmful enough for me to be concerned. I'm not an experienced enough gardener to tell you what could cause this. I apologize, but it hasn't really given me such a big problem to where like I need to be worried about. So I kind of just let them be. This is an early to mid season blooming camellia. So right now, third week of November, it is in bloom already. And let me show you how beautiful the flowers look, if my camera would just focus. Okay, there it is. So this is like a rose form camellia. Camellias come in many forms. You have single, semi-double, fully double. And with the fully doubled, you have a rose form, peony form, anemone form, and a formal double. And so this one is a rose form. It is so fluffy and elegant looking. It's so delicate. I mean, who wouldn't fall in love with this beauty? So it looks like a rose minus the fragrance. So camellia flowers don't have any fragrance to them. So this camellia, I mean, all of the camellias that I'm about to show you today, they're all Camellia japonica. And Camellia japonica are shade-loving camellias, which is why I keep them on my patio, which is kind of protected from full sun and also like from strong winds. I keep all my camellias in containers because I want to put them outside of my windows where I can like see them. And I have a south-facing patio, which gets like really, really strong afternoon sun in the summertime. So with containers, I can move them around to kind of avoid the strong sun. There are 2 types of camellias out there that are very popular that people use in their landscapes. One of them is Camellia japonica, which is the kinds that I have, and the other one is Camellia sasanqua. Camellia sasanqua is a more sun-tolerant camellias. It has slightly smaller blooms and smaller leaves, and it has like kind of like a more open form. So if you're if you have like a sun-facing patio, you might want to go with Camellia sasanqua. So this is my camellia debutante. I want you to take a look at the branches because I want to talk about Camellia espalier. If you want to train your camellia into like a little espalier, it is going to be so easy because the branches are super flexible. It's so easy to train. Okay, so that is the bloom of my Camellia debutante. I remember it blooming at the same time as my cherry blossom tree. My cherry blossom tree blooms twice, and the second time it blooms in November. My next one is Mrs. Tingley. This is also a Camellia japonica. Mrs. Tingley is kept in the same size container as my Camellia debutante, which is about 18 inches tall and wide. I've only had these camellias for about a year, and I think they're gonna be good in this size container for about another year or two even. Compared to my Camellia debutante, the leaves of Mrs. Tingley are smaller and narrower, and this is a mid to late season blooming camellia. So if you take a look at, okay, so take a look at the leaves. So that's a debutante, and then this is Miss Tingley. So you can see that, you know, Mrs. Tingley's leaves are a bit smaller and a bit narrower, but still, like, you know, glossy and medium green. Mrs. Tingley, if you take a look at her buds, you could see that her buds are a little bit smaller compared to debutante, because it's going to take a couple more weeks for the buds to, like, fully develop and swell up and getting ready to open up and into full blooms. So last year when I got this plant, I think I got it in like December, and it was like full of buds. But then January came and we had a snowstorm coming through, and I wasn't sure if it was going to survive, but it did, and it bloomed really, really well for me. So this was the bloom from last year. It has a perfect, like, double formal form. And then my next one is called Tom Knutson. This is a red camellia. I do not have any footage or any images of the blooms at all, because when I got it last year, it was already done blooming. But I keep this one in a slightly bigger container than the other two. This container is about 20 to 22 inches wide and about 18 inches tall. And it is also full of buds. I anticipate this one to open up in like December, right around Christmas time. And how fitting, you guys, because this is a red camellia and is going to open up like right around Christmas. In terms of the foliage characteristics, all of my four camellias have the same characteristics, in that the foliage is glossy green, looking very healthy all year. The branches are somewhat flexible right now because they're like super young plants. I've only had them for about a year or so. They're full of buds. Let's talk a little bit about the soil that it likes, because camellia is kind of like notorious for how fussy it is to grow. I haven't found that to be true at all. Like, they're really easy for me. When I planted these guys, I used Miracle-Gro moisture control soil, because, you know, these guys like to be consistently moist. They don't want to be overwatered or underwatered. So that soil really helped. And I water my camellias once a week. I do a deep watering once a week, and that's it. And in terms of fertilizing, I only do it like twice in the springtime, and I think that's all it takes. Camellias are not fussy if you know the right way to take care of them. Now, my fourth camellia that I want to show you today is Camellia tricolor. And it's such a beautiful camellia, and it's supposed to have three colors of flowers in one plant. It's supposed to be red, pink, and white, and sometimes some of the flowers are supposed to be variegated. And I say supposed to, because I have not seen this one in bloom either. I bought them last year when they were already done blooming, so I'm about to find out what it'll look like when the little buds start to open up. This is the side of my garden that is kind of like facing the north, which is like, it gets a lot of shade, and I could decide to put my camellias here, but you guys, I don't have any windows looking out onto this section unless I really come out of the house. And this part of my section is like a south facing side, which gets like a lot of sun in the summer, and my camellias are not going to do well. So personally for me, keeping my camellias in containers is my best option. This is the tag of my tricolor camellia that came with the plant, so that's what I have to look forward to. So that is all about me and my four camellias in containers. Winter may be long and gloomy, but I'll be okay because I have my beautiful camellia shrubs to look at. I wish everybody a happy Thanksgiving and happy gardening. Goodbye.